Hello everybody, welcome to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I want to start off the new year with a new series all about when beauty goes wrong, when skincare goes wrong. We're even going to touch on some makeup, and in this series we're going to talk about everything from botched Botox to skincare and makeup legal cases and how everyday cosmetics that could be in your home right now have caused serious harm to others. Now, it's just for fun, just general light entertainment, and for legal reasons, everything in these videos is alleged, in my opinion, personally, how I feel, allegedly. And I'll be doing my skincare through all these videos. We're going to be starting off with my morning routine, and let's get into it. We're going to start with one of the weirdest trends that I think I've ever seen on the internet. This is the lip balm craze that took over YouTube almost 7 years ago now. From ASMR channels to DIY channels, everyone, it felt like everyone was creating content around EOS lip balms, evolution of smooth. It's a really, really weird thing to go viral, I think. How does a lip balm go viral? We're going to talk about it. First of all, I'm going to jump in with my toner. This is the soybean nourishing toner from Round Lab, soothing, calming, etc. EOS, aka Evolution of Smooth, was founded as far back as 2006 by the CEO Jonathan Teller. They're known for making like lip balms primarily. You know, those round ones that are actually really difficult to hold and kind of annoying to use. But they're one of those brands that claim to be organic, all natural. They only use natural ingredients. And the packaging has kind of gone through quite a few evolutions. And the flavors, do you call lip balm flavors as well? Obviously the different formulations, but you know, it's a flavor, right? And I feel like they really got their kickstart by gifting their products to celebrities who are huge at the time, like Kim Kardashian, Hillary Duff, Britney Spears, paid or unpaid, I don't really know. The rules for advertising and like gifted and sponsored content weren't really around back then, but that really kicked off their popularity. And by 2015, they were the second highest selling lip balm product in the world. I'm guessing behind Nivea. Who else has famous lip balm? Blistex? I don't know. Probably Nivea. As I mentioned, their products were all over YouTube. There were some crazy videos out there. DIY EOS lip balm recipes, kind of normal. But then it got into things like Nutella lip balm, customizing your EOS packaging, making a giant EOS. There was even one that was like Shane Dawson's body part EOS or something. I don't know. Not my cup of tea. For obvious reasons. It wasn't a trend, actually, it was like a full-on movement. Whilst I never used EOS, I actually really enjoy the creativity and watching these people make stuff and make new lip balms. And, you know, I guess they were recycling and reusing their packaging. So yeah, I get it, the packaging's cute. And there's something super satisfying actually about the way you can coat both lips with your lip balm in one sweep. Next up, my essence. This is Jing Jun Sung's Soothing Moisture Skin Essence, Moisturizing Skin Essence. If you like a dewy glow that's not over the top, this is a perfect essence for you. However, along with huge success, of course comes some issues, controversies. And that's where the subject of the famous EOS lawsuit comes in, Rachael Cronin. Why would anyone want to sue a lip balm company, right? Like, what's it gonna do? What can it do to you? Well, let's check out Rachael's story, shall we? Rachael Cronin purchased an EOS lip balm. In fact, the flavor was summer fruits, on Friday, December the 4th at a Target in Los Angeles. However, when she came to using it, she didn't love it quite as much as all the celebrities, not quite as much as Britney, because it did this to her lips, supposedly, allegedly, for legal reasons. And at the height of EOS's popularity, on the 12th of January 2016, Rachael Cronin decided to sue EOS. So judging by the actual lawsuit, which we'll be going through in a minute, actually used the lip balm on the 6th of December 2015, and direct quote, by the next day, Miss Cronin's lips and surrounding skin area had severe blistering and rashes, causing her to seek medical care on Monday, December the 7th, 2015. Now, in her own words, Corin claims that within 48 hours of using the product for the first time, she's never used an EOS lip balm before supposedly, her lips became extremely dry and irritated. I mean, in her own words, but you can see what happened to her lips. They were flaking around the outside, she couldn't even fully open her mouth properly to talk or smile because her lips would crack, the skin around her lips would bleed, and her symptoms actually lasted 10 days. Sounds fucking horrific. Serum, This is the La Roche-Posay Roseliac AR Intense. This is supposed to help with redness when it comes to rosacea. And I must say, it's one of the better serums that targets rosacea. While there's no real cure for rosacea, this does seem to help with my flushing. I'm not sure about the ingredients. It seems like it's some kind of patented concoction. Now, of course, like any sensible person would, she actually contacted EOS. And someone on their medical health team got back to her and suggested she seeks medical attention, which she did. But they also told her that there's nothing inherently allergenic in EOS lip balms. So she was kind of like, well, you know, what do? What the fuck? So she posted her pictures on Facebook and she was swarmed with comments, replies, messages from people who feel like they had the same experience using an EOS lip balm. It's hard to prove that this kind of thing was from an EOS lip balm. You don't know what else they've been doing. Not saying they're lying, you know, just for legal reasons, we have to be careful. So Cronin and her lawyer, Mark J. Garagos, thought they had a good case here. Take them to court, get some money, maybe some free lip balm. I don't know. It's also important to note that Mark Garagos is pretty much considered a celebrity lawyer. He represented Winona Ryder after her shoplifting scandal, Michael Jackson during the Michael Jackson molestation case, and also Chris Brown, who Garagos bought to surrender to the LAPD after his assault of Rihanna. Of course, there was a media frenzy surrounding this. This was Britney's favorite lip balm. This was Kim Kardashian's favorite lip balm. So with all this attention and all this media frenzy going on, EOS were kind of forced to release a statement on their Facebook, which said as follows. Some of you may have seen reports of a lawsuit filed against our company. We wanted to be sure that you, our valued customers and fans, they're a celebrity, you see, know that the health and well-being of our customers is our top priority. Our products are safe to use and are made with the highest quality ingredients, and they all meet or exceed all safety and quality standards set out by our industry. For these reasons, we firmly believe this lawsuit is without merit. Thank you, EOS. Whilst telling ABC News that several million lip balms have been sold in the month of Cronin's complaint alone. And in that month, they had a complaint rate of 0.001%. So very low. We get it. No one complains about you. We get it. So my initial reaction to this is, it's skincare. Unfortunately, some people are going to react to things in certain ways that others don't. You know, the fact that a whole melange of things goes on your face, goes through your mouth, can pass your lips, it's hard to say whether this was the lip balm alone or not. You know, what else could she have used? So let's see what the dermatologist had to say. Dermatologist Tracy Kuykendall, may I pronounce that wrong, said that whilst reactions are generally rare, they are on the rise due to an increase of everyone using essential oils that are known to cause an allergic contact dermatitis. We know this. Essential oils on the face, not great. Whilst dermatologist Dr. Lauren Plotch said that as with all cosmetics that boast 100% natural claims, like EOS does, that people with allergies shouldn't be confused into thinking that natural equals better. We've heard that many times before. She goes on to say that just like how we can be allergic to fruits and plants, we can also be allergic to the oils that come from them when applied topically. Referring to essential oils, she also states that beeswax is a common allergen too. So taking a look at the main points of this lawsuit and what Cronin and Garagos are claiming. Honestly, they were kind of bitchy. They're kind of really bitchy. I'm going to go in with my galactomyces and niacinamide serum. All product links will, of course, be in the description box down below. Galactomyces for moisture and hydration and an anti-aging product, whilst niacinamide helps even out my skin tone and helps regulate sebum production. They say that despite the name being evolution of smooth, that, now let me get this right, in reality, behind the smoke and mirrors, EOS is anything but smooth. So the exact EOS products flavors that are in this lawsuit are blackberry nectar, coconut milk, strawberry sorbet, who says it like that, blueberry acai, acai, I never know how to say that. Pomegranate raspberry, summer fruits is the main culprit here. Sweet mint, honeysuckle honeydew, lemon drop, and medicated tangerine. They say how EOS present themselves as this all-natural, all-healthy lip balm, and the fact that they don't actually have any usage instructions on the packaging, allergen warnings, warnings in general, or disclaimers on their packaging, and how the brand have no clear instructions on the appropriate amount of lip balm to use. It's lip balm. You use it when your lips are dry, right? But this really wasn't the case with EOS. This was a fashion thing. This was a fashion trend. Who wouldn't want to be seen overly using some EOS lip balm, you know, the same one that Bella Thorne has, or Christina, or Demi Lovato, or Kylie Jenner, or Lance Bass, or One Direction at the time as well, or Kesha, or that lady from that really good Ghost program I watched that one time. Remember when the EOS health team contacted Rachael Cronin and said how the product had nothing inherently allergenic in it? Well, according to Cronin and the lawyer, this wasn't exactly true. So let's take a look at the ingredients. And I'm gonna read this off because it gets a bit confusing for me. They claim that ingredients which are combined and contained in the lip balm is cause for serious medical concern. Now I'm laughing because you have to remember this was 2016. Skincare and our knowledge on ingredients has come such a long way since then. One of the key ingredients that they raise as a concern is sodium hyaluronate. Hyaluronic acid, sodium hyaluronate is basically the sodium salt of hyaluronic acid, so smaller in molecular weight. They say that hyaluronic acid causes swelling and inflammation of the lips and can harm an this isn't funny, sorry, I'm laughing. And can harm an unborn baby if you're pregnant. They're reaching there. So sodium hyaluronate is in pretty much everything we use. Everything. They are reaching with this one, in my opinion. When it comes to what you should and shouldn't use when you're pregnant, there's not a lot of evidence to say that anything should or shouldn't be used when you're pregnant. However, it's sensible to discuss this kind of stuff with your doctor or the baby version of a doctor. Gynecologist? Nope. Ignore that. Shea butter, they move on to say, technically derives from a nut and can cause nut allergies. That might be true, I don't know. Vitamin C in here, in the form of ascorbyl palmitate, is apparently used at too high a percentage in their opinion. I'm not sure how they know the percentage of what's used in here because I didn't see it anywhere. I couldn't find it anywhere. This is a summer fruits lip balm, so it's most likely just the fact that there is a fruit in here with some vitamin C in. And that basically the claims by EOS that the products are healthy and safe and the omission of any warning or instruction is unfair, deceptive, and or unconscionable. Take that decor. So at the end of the day, who's gonna win this? Because this sounds a little bit like user error, but you've not warned me that I might be allergic to this. Is that like, I don't know. I mean, I know, but I don't know. My moisturizer is gonna be the Inky List Omega Water Cream. This is a really lightweight, super hydrating moisturizer. Think Rovectin Lotus Water versus Dewpoint, but with that slightly more hydrating kind of feel to it. So who wins? Well, everything kind of went quiet for the best part of a year. No news, Rachael Cronin wasn't doing her media tour, until BuzzFeed News did some digging. BuzzFeed actually managed to get their hands on the settlement agreement between EOS and Cronin. This basically stated in BuzzFeed's words that EOS lip balm will offer customers who complained of blisters and rashes around their mouths product compensation ranging from store credit to thousands of dollars under a preliminary agreement to settle 11 class action lawsuits. Under the terms of the settlement agreement obtained by BuzzFeed News, affected customers are eligible to receive either $75 for verified medical expenses, a $15 cash award, $20 worth of EOS products, or up to $4,000 depending on their injuries. Why would you want more EOS products if it fucked up your mouth? Can you imagine, like, oh, here's some more lip balm, like, thank you. And actually on December the 28th of 2017, so the end of the year that it all started, EOS posted their statement on their own website, along with a Q&A and links to references from the FDA, and basically further reading. They say that they are pleased that there is an amicable settlement of lawsuits. We stand behind our products and the ingredients we use. The settlement does not warrant any changes to EOS products, formulations, or imply any wrongdoing. All of our products meet or exceed all safety and quality standards set by our industry and are validated by rigorous safety testing conducted by independent labs. Whilst the rest of the page basically says, look, we're FDA approved. We did everything we needed to do to be able to sell our product. Our products are safe. The lawsuit has been settled, confirming that our products are safe. To finish off, I'm going to be using an SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. This is the Round Lab Birch sunscreen, moisturizing sunscreen. Again, all products in the description down below. So judging by that, Rachael Cronin either got a $4,000 reward or a voucher for more lip balm. No, I'm not laughing because it must be horrible. Like, as someone who enjoys skincare and tries to take pride in their appearance, I think for me to use something as simple as a lip balm and for it to do that to my skin, I'm going to be pissed too. And to finish off, of course, we need a lip balm. You need to moisturize your lips too. I'm going to, of course, be using EOS. I can't remember what one this is, but it's one of their crystal ones. I mean, look at it. Look at it. Look at it. In one sweep. And that's the thing, is everyone be out like this. Doing this. Posing with it like this. I mean, they look good. I get it. I do get it. I think with skincare and cosmetics, there's a fine line between using common sense on how to use a very basic everyday product and a brand needing to have clear usage instructions on their packaging. And I do feel that's the difference between a lip balm and, say, an at-home chemical peel. And with all skincare, unfortunately, you may just find that you are allergic to certain ingredients that other people are not. I do feel if brands are using things like essential oils, they should say there's a small chance you could be allergic to this. But also, that shouldn't put everyone off using it because not everyone is going to be allergic to the same thing. Is it unfortunate that some people have to find out the hard way, like myself and sulfur? Yes, absolutely. But I'm not about to take this brand to court. But if a brand has followed all the necessary guidelines and uses FDA approved ingredients, there's not a lot you can do. Or is there? That's for another day. I hope you enjoyed this first episode of When Beauty Goes Wrong. Bad? I don't know. I'll decide when I post the title. But yes, check out some general product reviews here, some nice products here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you next time.